what's up? I'm on my way to triage, which is like the labor and delivery part of a hospital. I don't have any symptoms of contractions or anything like that, or any pain either. I feel actually really great. But I think I might be leaking, like my water broke, but it's like leaking. So I'm not sure, but we're gonna go get it checked out. And
baby time! Woo! We're in our room. And that's where he's gonna go. Oh shit. And I gotta be tied up to all these stupid things. Oh, I hate it already.
Okay, it's December 24th, Christmas Eve. There's no one next to us. Christmas Eve, and we're about to be induced to go into labor to have. And this is the room, this is my bed, where I will push baby out of vagina. This, oh, I better not turn around and see the back side. This is baby bed when he comes out. This is Kevin's bed while we live here. And that's about it. Baby time.
We took the first pill, I don't remember what it was called, but dose of something that I set on my cheek to insert the process of labor. I came in yesterday, which was Monday, December 23rd, because I thought that I was leaking amniotic fluid. And then they tested it, but it came back negative. So I had a doctor's appointment on today, which is Christmas Eve, and my doctor just went ahead and did an ultrasound to check and make sure that the baby was in enough fluid, amniotic fluid, which he was not. So they sent me to the emergency room triage and put me on an IV, two big bags of IV, and then sent me back for contraction. Ooh, that's getting strong. Ay, 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 ay. I got this. Why is it, you wanna know what's so funny is every time a contraction starts to feel hard, I think of Cardi B. Money.
I want the money.
Anyways, so did another ultrasound and still not enough fluid, which basically means baby needs to come on out and join the party, right? So anyways, so the doctor decided that we will induce. I am 1 centimeter dilated and 50% effaced. So she at first was like, this is gonna be days, you're not gonna have them today, we're gonna start the process today, but you're probably not gonna have them today. However, I took the first dose of induced and I'm already having contractions, pretty good contractions. So this may be sooner than we think, which is awesome. I'm nervous for sure. I am not gonna lie. Pain is like, I don't feel like I'm very good at tolerating pain. Like even the IV in my arm is like still, I'm like not okay with it. I hate it. I want it out of me. But I've never gone through this, so maybe I'll be a freaking champion. All I know, either way, he has to come out, right? So best get over it. Overall, my energy is really high. I'm really happy. I'm really excited to meet my baby. It's kind of surreal to me now to think like there's going to be
a baby here.
Update on Kevin. He's doing really good. He's not here right now. I sent him to go get some last minute things. But he's really good. He's really excited. He's been super, my hair looks so strange in this video. He's super excited. His energies are high. He doesn't seem nervous at all. He's such a sweetie. So yeah, he's doing good too.
Ha ha ha!
So my contractions, I feel like I took that pill probably 3.5 hours ago, if not more. And my contractions now are 2 to 3 minutes apart and they're getting stronger, but nothing too crazy. Like I can totally handle it. It just feels like the muscle in my belly is just getting really tight and it holds on. I'm like, ooh, 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 ooh. And then it like releases. So I try to make sure that I'm breathing through my contractions, but also telling myself to like relax into the contractions. And this might sound silly, but I do sometimes when they're really hard, just say out loud, every contraction brings me closer to my baby. So, and like they have just been telling me like, there's no way to do this without having pain. Like it's a good thing. The pain is a good thing. That means I'm dilating. That means baby is getting ready to come. Contraction. You shouldn't breathe like that. You should actually. Anyways, I'm doing really good. I'll keep you guys updated. They are thinking that the baby will be here Christmas morning. So amazing. I hoped for a Christmas baby. I hope to either have a New Year's baby or a Christmas baby. So I'm super excited that he's being born on a holiday. I feel like if your birthday is that close to being on a holiday, like you might as well just have the holiday. So I'm just so grateful. Doing good. Okay, bye. I'm having contractions as if I'm 7 to 8 centimeters dilated, but I'm only 2 centimeters dilated and 50% effaced. So we don't want to stress out the baby, and he's not, he's totally good. So we're not gonna do another dose. We'll check again at 11 p.m. and see if we want to do one then, but we need to wait for my contractions to actually space out a little bit more before we do anything. I'm still feeling really good. The contractions have definitely gotten more painful, but I'm a boss, I can handle it. And that's pretty much it. So now they really want me to try to sleep because tomorrow is the big day and I need to rest. So I'm gonna try to sleep. Okay, it's 4:07 a.m. Christmas morning. My energy's not as high as it once was, but my attitude is still good. By about like 2, I basically got to the point where I was like, I can do this without jugs, but I don't want to. Not only that, but like I just haven't slept, and I was like, there's no way I could rest and sleep like going through those contractions every 3 minutes. Oh, I've got the shakes. So I was too scared to take an actual like painkiller because I hate the feeling of being out of control or loopy or buzzed or overdosed. I hate that. So awesome nurse just helped me decide like if I was going to do that or do the epidural. Either way, I knew I was going to 100% have an epidural, like no questions about it. So we just decided to go ahead and get the epidural, and that was an interesting experience. The epidural, it was very scary, but it was super fast. Like they called him, they got me in position, he came in, said something super quick, I didn't even really hear it, and then was like, do you have any questions? And I was like, I don't know. And he's like, arch your back as hard as you can like a cat, like just telling me to get in position. I was like, wait, wait, and he's like, do you have any questions? And I was like, I don't know. Is there anything I need to know? Because I'm not the mom that looked anything up or read reviews or things like that, because I just didn't want to get in my head about anything. So honestly, my IV hurt worse than the epidural did. I never got to see the needle. I never looked. But I heard it was big and I heard there was some blood, but it really wasn't that bad. There was like a moment where I was like, whoa. And then I was like, ow. And he's like, what are you feeling? And I was like, something is shooting down my tailbone. And he's like, on one side or the other. I was like, nope. Like right down the middle. That's what it felt like. So, I mean, glad I got the epidural. I don't think it was that bad at all. From there, I'm losing my train of thought. They got me into position to wait for everything to start before they gave me a catheter, and my blood pressure dropped like it was hot. And I was just talking to Kevin, and then I was like, holy cow, my full body sweats, clammy. And then I was like, I feel like I'm about to pass out or throw up. I'm not sure. Like, it was not fun. But I was like also weirdly relaxed. But so then I was okay, and my blood pressure started to go up, and the nurse came in and we told her, and she's like, okay, but you're feeling better. And I was like, yeah. And then again, woo. And I was like, Kevin, this is not okay. Like, I'm gonna pass out. And it was just really scary too. Like, I have the shakes, and I think it's just because it scared me so much. But it was just like what you feel like when your blood pressure drops, like hot, flash, clam, sweating from top to bottom. You kind of want to throw up, but you kind of just want to pass out. So my heart rate obviously dropped, which means babies drops. So they flipped me on my side. All these nurses rushed in. They gave me oxygen. I don't know what else they did, but because I was just trying to figure this out, told me to breathe, and then I'm fine now. But I do have the shakes, and I feel like I don't know if it's because I'm nervous, because now I'm really cold. I'm not sure. But anyways, the epidural has kicked in. I haven't been feeling contractions anymore, but I feel my toes. I mean, they're tingly, like my feet are tingly, but I can feel my toes. I'm not sure if that's normal or not. All right, it is 10:30 on Christmas Day. A contraction's coming. Hold, please. Okay, doing better. 10:30, Christmas morning, and my energy just kind of got better. Wasn't so great for the last little bit here. Ooh, contraction! I'll be back. I'm super itchy, by the way, from the epidural. Lethargic, tired, dizzy, kind of like how I was feeling before. But everything vital-wise was really good, so they just think that it's just a part of labor, and basically my body's been running a marathon. So yeah. So I am, also at 5 a.m. they checked me, and I was 5 centimeters dilated, and then they checked me again just a little bit ago, and I'm 8 centimeters. 2 hours ago I was 8 centimeters. And now big kicks, can feel a baby's head in my undercarriage. So any minute now, and he's kicking. Whoa. Okay, bye guys. Thank you.
Me too.
Thinking, huh, sir? Oh my goodness, look at that baby. Is that not daddy? Oh my gosh, that's so daddy.
That's so daddy. You winking at me? We're going home! Yay! He's really excited. He's just, we're all a little tired. That's all. You ready to go home? You ready to go home? Meet your fur brothers? Are you ready to go home, Daddy? Yes.
We're ready.
Daddy.